1788, Lamine County, in what's soon to be known as Idaho, Sacagawea was born unto her two parents, Smoke Lodge and Otter Woman. She was a part of the tribe Limhi Shoshone, that is until the age of 12, where she was captured by a raiding party near the Missouri River, where she was then enslaved. That was until she was purchased by Canadian French trader Toussaint Carboneau and became one of his many wives around 1804. In the winter of 1804, Meriwether Lewis and William Clark arrived at the Mandarin Hidista village, where they built Fort Mandarin, and decided to spend the winter there. Later on, they hired Charbonnet as an interpreter to accompany them on their trip. But they came upon a problem. They had no way of communicating to the people around them. So they found it best to take a pregnant Sacagawea along with them to communicate to her people. And as time passed, Sacagawea gave birth to Jean Baptiste Carbonnet on February 11th, 1805. Now, because she was part of the expedition, it helped de-escalate some of the situations that could have stopped it altogether, such as the time they came across a band of Indians led by her brother, Camoate. This was a reunion for the two, and because of that, it helped in Lewis and Clark's negotiations to get horses and navigation to cross the Rocky Mountain. Though there was a lot of mystery surrounding around how, when, and where Sacagawea actually died, it is believed that she died to sickness at Fort Manuel on December 20th, 1812. After 7 years of working with Lewis and Clark, Sacagawea became one of the most well-known women in American history. She even has her own stamp and a face on a coin. But today, we recognize her as one of the important people who helped in the expedition of the Louisiana Purchase.